Welcome to the Math Review. In this question, we're being asked what value of g makes the equation below true. But before we answer this question, you should totally help us help you and others better. How? By smashing that like button. And if this video helps you go from what to oh, then hit subscribe and share this video with a student or classmate that needs to do that too. Now, without further ado, let's crush that question. A lot of students see this word equation and right away they start to freak out. It's not that big of a deal. An equation is really just whenever you have a numerical statement and you have stuff on the left and you've got stuff on the right. And after all this is done, the left stuff has to be the same as the right stuff. That's all that means. Now, the reason it looks a little bit tricky is because it has this thing here called a variable. And a variable is just a letter that is holding the place for a number. And if you don't remember how to solve an equation, don't freak out. It's not a big deal. The reason why is because this is a multiple choice question, and that means that our answer is somewhere here. So let's just make sure that we set up our work so that we plug in each of these values for g to see which of these will create a true statement. So what I've done here is I've set up a little grid where I'm going to try each of these choices for this equation. So in each of these boxes, I'm going to start with g plus 2.7 equals 15. And then for box A, I'm going to try out the value for A. And then in box B, I'm going to try out the value for B. And then so on and so forth. Maybe we'll get lucky and our answer will be one of these first choices. And we don't have to do the rest. So let's see if that works out. So let's try out choice A, 12.3. So if we're saying that G represents 12.3, then that just means wherever I see G, instead of writing G, I'll write 12.3. So G in choice A would be 12.3 plus 2.7. Now here's the thing. When we're adding numbers like this, we have to make sure we remember that we're adding decimals, and that means we have to use our decimal point to line up our place values. So I'll actually do it over here. So I'll put 12.3, and then I'll add under it 2.7, making sure that the decimal points are lined up. I'll put my 7 right next to the decimal under the 3, and then the 2 to the left of the decimal under this 2. Now when I add these up, I get 7 plus 3, which is 10. That's a two-digit number. So I'll bring down my 0, and I'll carry the 1 here, and I'll make sure I put my decimal point here underneath my other decimal points. Then I've got 2 plus 2, which is 4, and 4 plus 1, which is 5, and 1 plus nothing is just 1. So 15.0 is the same exact thing as 15. And since this does equal 15, that makes this a true statement. And that means the value of g is 12.3, or properly read as 12 3/10. So therefore, our answer is A, and we're done. Now I'm also going to make sure that I go through all the other choices. You don't have to watch the rest, but I just want to make sure that I reinforce the fact that whenever you're adding decimals, you must make sure you line up the decimal point. So if we're doing choice B, 12.7 would be where G goes. So that would be 12.7 here. And I would add 2.7 to that. And notice how I made sure I lined up my decimal points here, and that allowed me to line up my place values properly. So we've got 7 plus 7 is 14. That's a two-digit number, so I'll bring down a 4, and I'll carry the 1 here. And I've got to make sure I put a decimal point in my answer directly under my decimal points in the question. So I'll put a decimal point here. I've got 2 plus 2 is 4, plus this 1 is 5. And then 1 plus nothing is 1. And unfortunately, that is absolutely incorrect. The reason why is it's not equal to 15. It's equal to 15.4. Therefore, G cannot be 12.7. Let's do the same thing here. For choice C, we're saying that G would equal 13.3. All right, so we've got 13.3. I'm going to put that here for G. 13.3. And when I put 2.7 under it, I'll make sure I use a decimal point here to line everything up. I've got point here, 7 here, directly next to the decimal point, under the 3, and the 2 will be to the left of the decimal point under this 3. When I add everything up, I've got 7 plus 3 is 10, and that is 0, and I will carry the 1 to the next place value. My decimal points here mean that I'll have a decimal point and my answer directly under them. Now I've got 3 plus 2, which is 5. And though that might look like it's going to be 15, don't forget about the one you carried. So that's going to be 16. So that's going to be 6. And then this 1 here would make it 16. And therefore, this is also incorrect. Because remember, we're looking to make 15 when we use a value for G. And next we'll go to choice D. And for choice D, we're saying the answer for G is 17.7. So wherever I see G, I'll put 17.7. I'll use the decimal point to line my place values up. I'll put my decimal point here. I'll put this 7 directly next to the decimal point under this 7. And I'll put the 2 directly next to the decimal point on this side under this 7 here, 17. Then I'll put a plus sign. And now I'll start to add everything. We've got 7 plus 7 is 14. That is a two-digit number, which means I'm going to bring down that 4 in 14 and carry the 1 in 14 to the next column. I've got my decimal point here and here, which means the 1 in my answer will go right here. 7 plus 2 is 9, plus this 1 I carried is 10. So I'll bring down a 0 and carry the 1. Now I've got 1 plus 1, and that's 2. Therefore, my answer here, when G equals 17.7, the value of the left side would equal 20.4, which does not equal 15. And therefore, choice D is also incorrect. Thanks for watching our video on the math review. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. We might use your question in our next video. And if you found this lesson helpful, please make sure you like and subscribe to our channel. And it would really help if you share this and our other videos to any of your social media platforms. See you next time on The Math Review.